Afghanistan, Kabul.
Makeshift ambulances brought them in this morning as Kabul's hospitals were overwhelmed. At least 80 people killed when a huge truck bomb exploded during rush hour. Several hundred people were injured. It is one of the worst bomb attacks in Afghanistan in years.
I heard a terrible sound and became unconscious. I opened my eyes and found myself under the desk. Blood was coming out of my shoulder. It was a dreadful explosion.
This video, taken miles from the blast, shows how powerful it was. The BBC's Harun Najafizadeh has been at the scene.
It was a water tanker or a lorry full of explosive that hit this strategic location right in the heart of Kabul. It's very close to the German embassy, Indian embassy, French and British embassies.
Explosion only a short distance from Afghanistan's presidential palace. This is the German embassy today, badly damaged. Germany's foreign minister said the unimaginable death toll was proof that terror continues to target Western institutions, but also local people. A BBC team were in the area and hit by the blast, killing driver Mohammed Nazir. The BBC described him as a popular colleague with a young family. NATO and some British troops are still based in Afghanistan, but the fact that militants were able to get such a large bomb into the city's heavily guarded political zone shows how fragile Afghanistan's security picture has become. So far, neither the Taliban nor the so-called Islamic State in Afghanistan have claimed responsibility. Attacks in Kabul are not unusual, but this was a bombing on another scale. Among the dead, women and children. Tom Burridge, CBS News.